If you haven't taken notice, the Yankees' youth movement began last offseason when they acquired 25-year-old shortstop Didi Gregorius. This winter, they added 25-year-old second baseman Starlin Castro and 26-year-old outfielder Aaron Hicks. The offense still revolves around a bunch of 30-somethings and one 40-something named A-Rod. But the balance of the roster has shifted, and it should help make this roster more flexible.
I think it helps in rotations of making sure that guys are rested and healthy. You look at Hicks, he's an outstanding athlete. Castro's a good athlete. That helps. You know, Steve and Drew was a pretty good athlete, too, as he played. But obviously, we're younger. I think there's more speed there, and they give us options.
Castro has more hurdles to clear than the normal star player from another team coming to New York. He's a starting second baseman, a position he only started to get familiar with last year. And he'll also take reps at third base to maybe spell Chase Headley from time to time.
I think it's going to be tough for me in the beginning to be prepared and be ready to play out there every day. You know, after the first four games that I played there, it's a feel really difficult, especially to make the double plays. But after that, just getting work every day, hard everywhere, and start to get confident and feel really good out there too.
Everybody knows what he's been doing in all his career, so everybody's following. You know what he's been doing, so he's great. Great offensive and defensive, and a great guy, so he's really good to work with.
Hicks takes over Chris Young's spot as the fourth outfielder, but as a switch hitter, he's expected to see much more time than Young did, rotating around to help keep Jacoby Ellsbury, Brett Gardner, and Carlos Beltran fresh.
Pretty much I'm just going to come here and help keep guys on the field, you know, so I'm here to play and you know, whatever that role becomes, you know, I'll be ready for it.
Last year's Yankees offense stumbled to the finish because they became too left-handed and too station-to-station. Those are problems the Yankees hope to solve with the additions of Castro and Hicks. They weren't as splashy as moves that some other teams made in the AL East, but they do continue the trend the Yankees began in 2015. With the Yankees in Tampa, I'm Sweeney Murdy, SNY.